Welcome to another episode of OS First Timer. In this episode, Diana will be trying out SymbOS 2.0 released in 2007. Although the operating system was released recently, it is an 8-bit multitasking OS coded to run on Z80-based 8-bit computers built and used in the 1980s. We will be running this operating system as if it was running on an Amstrad CPC, which stands for Color Personal Computer. This was a series of personal computers produced between 1984 to 1990, designed to compete with the Commodore 64 and ZX Spectrum. Now, if you look at this image of the actual computer, you can see that it's got a big keyboard here. Now, the reason the keyboard is so thick to compare to, say, like one of these keyboards I've got here is because it's actually got the computer tower, or the computer itself, built into the keyboard, along with a little tape deck and a floppy disk drive, and then you just plug that into the monitor. What do you think about it all being connected and all in one?
I think it's pretty good all in one. Easier to transport, easier to, know what's there, etc. I remember mine had a separate tape deck.
So what was yours? You had a...
I had a TRS-80.
Okay, and that would have been one of the competitors of this computer back then.
Yeah. Funny thing, I remember the Commodore 64 being a main competitor to TRS-80, but I don't remember the Amstrad.
Okay, but this was Australia you grew up in, so maybe this was more of an American thing.
Probably was.
Yeah. Yeah. Tell us in the comments. Okay. Now, just one thing I want to comment on. Look at the difference between this keyboard and this keyboard. So this is the keyboard I use for my computer on a day-to-day basis. It's nice, it's thin, and as you can see, it's got an arc shape, which is very, very good for ergonomic purposes. So here, your fingers, everything is relaxed. It's natural and it's in its natural curve. If it didn't have this curve, the keyboard, your fingers would have to be doing that, and that's not natural for them. Your wrist can lay very nicely on the table, but look at this computer. Look how thick it is. Think about how thick it is. You basically pretend this is like the thickness of that computer there. You'd be doing this with the keyboard if you're trying to rest it. You'd have to really type like this. You wouldn't be able to just rest your hand because it's so thick.
I guess that's how RSI started.
Yeah, and that's why it started in the 80s. Because they were so awful with the ergonomic stuff. They didn't have this problem with typewriters. But look at this. I'm sorry, but that design is just awful.
Yeah, well, it's easy to say in hindsight, but back then,
they didn't
know any better, so, okay.
Now, on the screen, what you're seeing is the classic 1980s Amstrad CPC basic screen. So this is like where you can basically type in basic code and start doing it like this, just like you would on the TRS-80 and that kind of thing. So, just have a little type to see if it actually responds.
Run.
And there we go. So, it is actually writing stuff, but you didn't actually tell it what to run. So, it's like, huh?
Operating system.
So, the operating system you're going to be running is made in 2007, and the guy who made it wants to prove that old computers can run operating systems that look and act modern, even though it's such an old computer. So basically, SymbOS runs off a floppy disk like the one my mum sold me now. You simply insert it into the computer. And then we're ready to run it.
Okay.
Now that you've inserted the disk, you now need to actually run the file on the disk that will actually get it up. So you need to type in run.
But that's what I just did.
No, but first of all, type in run, but don't press enter. Now hold shift and press 2. Fantastic, that brings up a little quotation mark. And now you need to type in SYM1MB. And now press enter. So right now it's going
sounds like a marching band. Now it sounds like we're playing Space Invaders.
Okay. Basically now, it's loaded up the operating system off the floppy disk, but the thing is, look at the screen. Have you noticed how it's all black edges?
Yeah.
Now, at this point I'm thinking, what's wrong with the screen? I've got to fix this. And I spent hours looking for how to fix this. Like, I'm thinking, there's a problem with the screen, it's not working properly.
Yeah.
right? Because think, it was full blue screen before, yeah, and now suddenly it's all compressed. But look at this. This is actually an image from the 1980s, okay? And it shows two children playing a game on one of these computers. See, with the big keyboard, yeah. They've got some kind of, I don't know, a joystick or something they're plugged in. They're playing a game, Paperboy or something. Now, look on the screen. What do you notice?
Oh, it's the same thing. It's small.
Black.
Why didn't they
edges.
Just use smaller screens so that they could be the size of the image?
Yeah, but think when it's actually full screen, it's actually able to run full. Remember when it was blue? It's just when it's displaying graphic type things, it seems to not be able to display it on the whole screen. I heard something about it running in mode 1 and all these different types of modes, which is like screen resolutions
right,
and stuff. Like
right.
The higher the graphics you set, the smaller the screen resolution. Because it just doesn't have, you know, enough memory or whatever it is to store that much information on the screen. So
okay.
It has to compress it a little. Now, just looking at this screen, at the operating system, what is the first thing you see when you look at the GUI? Does it remind you of any other operating system?
Not particularly. I mean, it's sort of Windows-y in a way that it's got icons on it.
Icons plus
the start
time in the corner,
menu,
the word
yeah.
start, and look at this.
Oh, okay.
It's like a start menu. Now, this is running on a 1980s computer before that, like Windows. Like, this is pretty much looking like Windows 95. Development started in the year 2000 of this operating system.
Yes.
Now, doesn't that just scream Windows 95 to you?
It does, actually, yeah.
This is running on a computer that was made before Windows 95 or something like that would have been supported. So this is actually a modern kind of interface here.
Mm.
Running on an old 1980s computer, isn't that just, does that kind of boggle your mind a little bit?
I don't really think about it that much.
So, okay.
Yeah.
Now, there's another thing on the screen I want to tell you. What do you notice about the colours?
It's very fiery. It's like red, orange.
Something specific. Very specific about the pixels.
Oh, it's very pixelated. I mean, look at that.
Well, that's number one.
not good graphics.
Yeah, because the computer couldn't really handle it. I think it's only running at like 320 by something. But what do you notice about the colours of the pixels? How many colours are there?
There's not many colours. It's very limited. There are only about four colours.
You're right. Snap-on, there's only four colours that can be displayed on the screen at once.
Okay.
Four colours.
Oh,
so if you look at this, you can see the colours in this background. There's black.
Yes.
And you can see they've used some black here and here and here. There's this light, almost white colour, but it's not white.
Yeah, off-white.
There's like an orange and a dark orange, and that's the four colours in the screen, in the whole system.
Yeah.
No other colours.
Yeah, I can see that.
So that means every picture you have, every video you have, it'll all only have four colours in it.
Do you get to choose which four colours you want?
Yeah, you can alter that. But the system can only display four colours at once.
Okay.
Unless you're running like...
Can you mix the colours to create more?
No, it can only display four colours at once. So you can mix current colours, but as soon as you mix those two into one,
let's say
with the RGB values or whatever you're going to use...
Yeah.
It just... You can't use the original two. You have to just use that one with, you know, the four,
okay.
three others.
And you can't have pixels overlapping with each other to create different colours?
No transparency.
Okay.
So your first task is, what time is it?
Oh, easy, 2:25.
Now, we've only got one floppy in the computer right now, but that isn't enough to actually get this operating system fully working, because it was such a big operating system taking up so much memory for such an old computer that the actual bootable operating systems and the applications had to be stored on two different separate floppy disks.
So the other floppy disk simply got that
Yeah, got this up. And now we put in this floppy disk, so put that in, and that'll get us the application. So all those icons on the desktop, you can't even run those. You
well,
get it?
That's ridiculous. Why don't you just put all the floppies in at once?
So you're saying put everything on the one floppy, because the floppy couldn't store that much. So we've got drive A and B. Drive A right now has all the bootable system,
yes.
And drive B has all the applications.
Okay.
Now, usually the next task is write, save and open a text document. However, the Notepad application is not actually in this version, okay? In version 2.1 preview from 2012, there is a Notepad application, but you're using the 2007 version right now because the preview version isn't a real proper full release, and I wanted to show a proper full release. So we're going to skip that task and we'll just do some other ones instead. Okay, now that you have access to the applications disk and that you've put your hair back, can you now try and use a file browser, right, to view the files on drive B? where the applications are, and try to find a calculator to calculate 15 times 65.
Okay, well, that looks like file A, but it doesn't have a file B. Is there another floppy I have to insert to get a B?
No. Now, that system shell, that's like a command line, CLI, command line. You get it? So that would be typing commands. Do you really want to be doing that?
No.
Or do you want an actual file browser where you're actually...
I would like a file.
Searching through folders with a magnifying glass.
Oh, okay. So...
But where were you going to go before I...
Well, I was actually just going to go there and just see if there's any B drive things there.
Yeah.
But there isn't.
Yeah.
So I'll go there where the magnifying glass is.
Yeah, double click. Ah, okay, wait, let me... It actually wants the applications to be in drive A and the other floppy disk to be in drive B.
Right.
So can you just swap them around? Okay, now that you've swapped them around, it should work. So open it up. Because it's looking for applications on drive A rather than drive B. Double click.
Okay. Constantly got a marching band with every command.
There we go. What do you think about the speed of it?
Oh, it's not too bad. I mean...
So it's usable. Seems,
yeah, it is.
What do you see here? What's this?
A list of words that don't make sense.
So it's got all the files on drive A here and all the files on drive A here.
Well, don't we need all the files on B?
Well, drive A is where the applications are. Drive B, I'll just show you, contains just, you know, the basic operating system stuff.
All right, okay.
Okay, like all the SymOS. That's actually the file you opened originally, symb1megabyte.bas. So now try and find a calculator application. Look through these file names and think, oh, where is the calculator application going to be?
Okay. I can't see. Oh, calc. It was right at the beginning. I didn't.
Look at the date, file date, 1984. Okay, there you go. So 15 times 65.
There we go.
Do you think this is designed really well? Do you think this is a good example of how, even though a 1980s computer is so old and you're using all this like text-based stuff, do you think it's great to see that someone's actually been able to use such an old system to create what looks like such a modern operating system to compare to like a command line interface?
I guess so, but I don't see the real point in it. I mean, who's using a 1985 computer?
There are still people and some businesses, yes. The internet says that there's some people and businesses using these old Amstrad, I can't even remember you call them, CPCs. So they are apparently still in use. And I'd prefer to use them like this if I had to use... Well, let's just say if you accidentally downloaded this operating system, had a floppy disk in your hand containing this operating system and accidentally time-travelled back to 1980s, it would be very nice to be able to use a computer like this rather than having to type commands.
Oh, yeah, well, I guess in that respect, if I accidentally did all those things, I would be very grateful now.
Okay. Yeah. Now, we're going to be looking at some images. See how, like, this actual operating system can view images. And we're going to set a desktop background. Okay. But, once again, they're stored on another floppy disk.
Another one. Right.
So take the operating system one out that actually contains the operating system. Notice that the operating system, even though you took that floppy disk out of the computer, it is still able to run. Now insert the new one. Okay, fantastic. And just refresh this. See how this says B? Now you'll see that B contains a different list. So we'll just go back to drive A, which is the applications. Now, the image floppy disk that you just put in is there. We can see some images on it.
Mm-hmm.
See how the system can still run, even though you've taken out the original thing required for it to boot.
Yeah.
That's pretty good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Can you now view these images?
I'm assuming I just double-click on them. Drum roll. Must be a pretty good image. There we go.
There it is. What do you think of it?
Yeah, a castle. Pretty nice, though.
Now, what did it open in? What's the program called?
SymC.
And notice it's a multitasking operating system because you can actually see all the files at the bottom there, just like a taskbar, as if it was in Windows.
Yeah.
Now, do you think that's a good name for the program, SymC? Do you think that's what you would call a good name for an image viewer, SymC?
I personally wouldn't call it SymC. I'd just call it Image Viewer.
No, but that's like an internet browser. Like, let's say you wanted to start up your own internet browser and you call it Internet Browser.
Well, it's to the point.
No, but the thing is, then Firefox, people are typing in internet browsers looking for five, you know, and it's just an internet browser. It has to have a name.
Well, you asked my opinion, that was my answer.
So you would call an image viewer, image viewer.
Yeah.
A video viewer, video watcher.
No, video viewer.
Video player sounds a bit better.
Actually, yeah, video player, that's right. Just get to the point.
But then what happens in the future when we've got 20 different companies all making things called
image
video
viewer
player?
One, image viewer 2, image viewer 3.
And then that's ridiculous. It's like, oh, buy the new Image Viewer 6,
okay, well,
better than Image Viewer 21.
Name, the company's name, then Image Viewer. The company's name, then Image Viewer.
Okay, so Windows Image
nice,
Viewer, Mac
yeah,
Image Viewer.
Exactly.
Ubuntu Image Viewer.
Yeah.
So you think that's how it should be?
Yeah, I do.
So instead of SymC, it should be Sym Image Viewer.
Yeah.
So Mozilla Web Browser, you'd prefer to call Firefox.
Well, it's to the point, you know exactly what it is. For somebody who didn't know what a Firefox is, they'd know what that is.
Okay.
Bit of a mouthful, but, you know.
A Microsoft Internet Browser.
Instead of Chrome.
No, a Google Internet Browser would be Chrome.
What's a Microsoft Image Viewer?
Internet Explorer is the usual thing, but it would be called Microsoft Internet Browser.
Oh, well, look, it's to the point.
Okay, so can you look at a few of these images? In fact, let's give you a challenge. Try and make this image like a slideshow. Try and make a slideshow.
Okay, well...
an automatic slideshow.
Full.
That's full screen, that's not a slideshow.
Okay.
How do you escape full screen?
Escape?
I gave that one away. How do you escape? I need to say, how do you get out of full screen?
Well, I would, yeah, okay.
Okay.
Options, random order. That'll do. Start slideshow.
So it's looking at all the images on drive B and it'll just keep changing between them. Every 5 seconds you set it as. So you tell me when you see a good desktop background and you feel, yep, I want that.
No. Oh, that's awful. Wouldn't like that. Don't even know what it's holding. I don't know about that. No.
So you don't like any of these?
No, not really.
What about that one of the castle that you saw? Castle one?
Let me just see more. Do that.
Oh, that one. Okay, with the horses.
Yeah.
Now let's see. Look at the name of it. It's called greatdawn.sgx.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you want to set that as your desktop background.
Okay.
So what's it called? So how do you think you'll change the desktop background?
I'm assuming perhaps go to control panel.
Okay, you can try that. Double click.
I guess, though, I would start getting sick of the drum roll every time I do something. It makes it sound as if it's trying to be dramatic and that every single thing I do is so important.
That's just reading the sound, and I don't think it's even that loud.
Display.
Okay.
That looks about...
Double click. There you go, and it says background.
Yes.
And those are the colours. Look at that.
Yeah.
The colours it's using, those 4 pixels.
So you can browse.
So you can browse to change it. So go on to floppy B. So that's floppy A. Change it to floppy B.
Yes.
And that's the images. So remember the one, what was the one you wanted?
One.
Great Dawn, yep. And there we go. You changed it.
Can I
background.
Change the colours? So
we'll try and change the colours. How do you think you'll change the colours?
Oh, no.
Those are the 4
does.
Colours. So that's just displaying the colours on the screen.
Hmm.
How would you actually change those colours?
I don't know. Oh, colours. Wait a sec. Colours.
Okay.
Colours.
Go to
I'd
colours.
Go there.
Oh, there's palette, so you could change the palette colours.
Oh, but you can't, like, have blue or different
ones.
No. Wait,
no.
Let me just go there first and just
Yeah, tick that so it does have the screen.
Then I'm there.
Now, this is the palette for that colour.
Yeah.
So you're going to be changing that white colour, I think.
Well, it hasn't done anything.
We'll change a few more of them.
Oh.
Oh, see, so you've changed that colour to blue, so that changes all the things blue there. Oh, that looks good because it's a blue... I don't know.
Yeah, wait a sec.
Blue sky. So that's for that colour.
Let
for that
me have
blue.
A bit of fun here. Oh, that's green. No, I want the blue.
So this actually is an RGB value thing. You're saying you want this colour to have almost no red, quite a bit of green, and mostly blue.
Yeah.
You get it how it's working? RGB, red, green, blue. You're happy on that colour?
Yeah, that'll do.
Okay. You don't want to change the other ones? Just keep them the same, the orange?
Just...
Yep.
Actually, yeah, I do want to change the others. How do I go
okay.
about it?
Okay. colours. Okay, so how would you change another colour?
Okay, I click on it.
So black is actually no red, no green, and no...
Don't like that. I like a bit of definition to it.
Do you like a bit of green?
Oh, that just looks a bit sick. Oh, no. I think I'll just keep that one.
Yeah, pretty black, yeah.
Oh.
Oops, you click back. Let's click back there.
Yeah.
Get back into it, yep. Do you want some blue in it or not? You're starting to regret this, aren't you?
Yeah, I am actually.
Because you've made it look...
Oh, that looks really bad.
The whole screen just looks sickly.
Oh, look. That's just going to do. And what about this one now? Oh, that changed. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, there we go. Apply. Done.
Okay. If you haven't seen any of our previous videos, know that whenever she tries to customise the colours of one of these old operating systems, it always looks radioactive or awful pink and ugh.
But that doesn't look too bad. That looks quite nice.
I preferred it the way it was before, but okay. So now we're going to play some music with SymbOS.
Another floppy.
Yeah.
Wow. What if we just have an automatic... changing disk. You know how modern day has an automatic...
I don't know if they had floppy, but I don't think they had that built into that old system.
So take another one out or...
Yep, take that other one out. And put that one in. Okay, good. Now, let's go back to the sim commander and look at the proper... See, those were all the images. We've just got to refresh it. So, remembers. Okay, B. Okay, now find... Try listen to some of these applications, but try and open the actual application first before you start opening these files. See if you can guess what the application might be called.
Info. That's probably got a whole stack of information for you. Dump. That's probably a bin. Rubbish bin.
Okay. What about an application to play music? What do you think that one is? P-A-C-M-N.
Pac-Man.
Have a look. See if it is. Go, quick.
Oh, where am I? Which one am I?
Wait.
Ah, which one am I?
Wait, you've got to click start first.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Then you use the arrow keys. Ready?
Go.
Arrow keys.
Wait.
Go.
Oh, no. Down.
Oh, wait.
Where's the arrow keys?
This is the arrow keys here.
Okay,
ready, set, go. I'll just move that mouse out of the way. Does it feel pretty funny?
No, I don't.
No, yeah, they got you.
Oh, that's a bit rough.
Okay, there we go. I'll quit that now. You don't want it one more turn?
I do, actually.
Okay.
Oh, no. I didn't get very far.
Remember that if... Yeah,
I don't like the arrows. I like the old joystick. Oh, where am I? I'm not even there.
You've lost 3 lives. Do you want one more go?
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go. So, remember, if you get those, then you can eat them. The bad ones.
I want to try and get to it, but I'm having a lot of trouble with these arrow keys. Oh, these arrow keys don't work. Your computer's faulty.
That's why if I ever need to use the arrow keys, I use my other keyboard.
No, the arrow keys are bad. I don't want to play anymore.
See, this is the only complaint I have about this. The arrow keys are like this. It needs to be, like, a proper keyboard with the 4 arrow keys.
Ridiculous.
Okay, I'll quit that now. What do you think about that Pac-Man, like, just built in like that?
Well, if it had a bit of... If it actually had a joystick, it would be good, yeah.
Yeah, well, think about the real computer it does.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this one's just, yeah.
Okay. App ROM. These are like Apple apps, aren't they? App shell.
Okay.
App snap. Playing snap.
Just try and find. Whenever
Apps
you think,
Yamp.
Whenever you think you've found a music application, double click it.
I can't see any music. Calculator, commander, dump, info, mine. Is that Minecraft?
Well, have a look. Minesweeper.
Oh, okay. I used to love that. Speak.
Try speak. Because think maybe audio. Speak. Sound. So what you do here is it says speech and it's got a mouth. So try typing something for it to say, like a little sentence.
Yep.
And then what do you do?
Oh, right.
Did you hear it? Like, hello, I am talking.
Yeah, very robotic. Oh, that's really cute. I'm going to try something else.
And you can change the pitch too, so it doesn't have to be hello. You can be hello, I am talking, or hello, I'm talking.
Wait, what is this the pitch?
So that would be lower, and that would be higher pitched. There okay. you go, so 13. But what are you going to say? What's the difference between say and speak?
I don't know, okay. I am speaking, so let's see that. Maybe it's in a different language. Computer language.
Say something that isn't just I am doing something.
I am saying.
I like saying than
yeah,
speaking.
Yeah, I think
they're... Oops. Oh, you'd always... Stop highlighting. I am a dicky.
No, dickhead.
Okay, just go. Did I just say dicky? I'm psychic. I knew what you said.
It doesn't stop.
What? No, I can't get out of it. He's being annoying. He's a dickhead. I can't even click on anything. Right? Okay, now, say something related to our YouTube channel. Something long. See if you can say something really long on YouTube or something like that.
Okay. Oh, wait a sec. There needs to be a space there.
Let's see, ready?
Okay. Yeah, okay.
But think about it, that's not like speech recognition, it's not someone who's been recording in, you see?
Yeah.
That's why it's interesting that it's able to convert those letters and stuff to speech.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, we'll close that.
It seems to be talking really quickly. Just go back into it. I want to see what happens if I make it slow down.
What do you mean?
Well, you'll see. Go back. Now, let's see. That sounds a bit strange.
Yeah. Sounds a bit demonic.
It does, actually.
So, how are you going with trying to find an application?
Yeah, they, you know, kind of say what they are. Video.
You still haven't found the music player. You're supposed to play some music.
Can I watch YouTube videos on that?
You can download one, convert it to a format compatible with the computer and watch a good 5-second video, sure.
Okay. Well, I've forgotten now what I'm supposed to be doing. Got a bit sidetracked.
You've got some music here.
Oh, to play
find an application that can play the music.
Hip-hop.
No, don't click it, though. That's you're supposed to find an application here.
Video. Where is he?
I'll give you a clue. Sometimes in music, people use, like, a guitar amp.
Amp?
Yeah, a guitar amp. You know how some people have
so
guitars?
So this?
Yes.
Oh, drum roll again.
There we go. Play some music with it. So over here, you've got Playlist Editor, which is a separate, like, little application, and then you've got here the System Amp, which actually can choose a file to play.
Okay, well, where's the...
Files? Play... What are you going to do? No, not open Play More. If you want to open a playlist, you can, but if you wanted to play a single file, how would you do that?
Play file.
And what drive is it on? It's on B.
The B.
Yep.
Which is that drive.
And there we go. Choose a music to play. You think it's good that it can play music? What do you think? Another one?
Well, I must say that it's music seems to be a little bit more advanced than its graphics.
Okay. What one now? Devil?
Okay. Doesn't seem very devilish to me.
What would you call devilish?
Well, not that. Feelings. I want to go to feelings.
Okay. Do you think this is pretty much the most advanced thing this operating system can do?
Yeah, it seems to have a wider range of sounds, and yeah, then it does like with graphics type thing.
Now
colours.
Think about it like this, because it's a multitasking now, isn't this cool? You could have this music playing multitasking in the background.
Oh yeah, you could just hold a disco in your own house.
Yeah,
fantastic.
While you're playing Pac-Man.
Oh,
or
wow,
while you're looking
yeah.
at those images. Wouldn't that be cool?
What about all the discs?
Yeah, yeah. Gotta have lots of discs.
Maybe you need to get more drives in your computer, disc drives, to fit all the discs in.
Yeah, but I don't know how much. I think it can only support two.
Okay.
So just quit all the programs and then just give me a little review of what you think of SymbOS.
I actually like my little desktop background there. I like it. I think I created it quite nice.
Yeah, you
look
should.
The sea and the sky and,
the
know?
Pink dirt.
I wouldn't mind
yellow,
just changing that to a sort of greeny
brown.
Colour. No, greeny colour.
Do you know what? I've just noticed, look, blue, yellow, like sand, and then if that was a brown.
If that was green, that would be really good. Can we just do that?
So if you want lots of green in this pink here, what would you do? You'd put green up the top and then red and blue with nothing, because right now you've got no green, so why are you putting red up?
Oh, that's too bad.
So you need some green in this. So you've got no green. That means you're full green.
Oh,
you get it?
So that's full green.
That's full green. Now you've got a little bit of red. If you turn that off and then blue off, then there'll be no blue, so it'll be just green. So if you want it to be just green, just have green up there and blue and red gone. All of them across at the top, all colours, that makes it white.
I don't understand.
So put the red away and then it'll be just green. Keep getting the red away more. See, now that's pure green.
But I don't like it. It's not a natural green.
So what do you want to add to it, a bit of blue or a bit of red to that green?
I think a bit of blue. Dark. Oh.
Oh, okay. There we go. So you've got dark green. There you go. But you didn't apply.
Oh.
Okay. I think
that'll
we give
do.
Up.
That'll do.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
So, what do you think of SymbOS?
I don't really see the point. I mean, I must admit, I'm impressed by its audio.
And think about the person who has done this as a hobby kind of thing.
Yeah, well, look, it's
doing
pretty
something
clever.
Like this.
I mean, I will admit, they would have had to have been very clever to be able to
yeah.
do this. But I just can't see a person using a 1980s computer buying a 2007 operating system for their 1980s computer.
Well, they're not buying it. It's free. He's released it for free for everyone.
Well, that's pretty generous, isn't it?
Yeah. So he's done all this work for free.
Well, not only is he clever, he's very generous. Well, look at it this way. I guess if you had a 1980s computer and you didn't want to just simply have commands.
They still sell these computers if you want them, one of those 1980s computers. Literally.
Yeah.
You can go and buy them.
That's
brand
okay.
new.
I've had enough. but basically, I just think for a 1980s computer, this is a fantastic operating system if you don't mind changing floppies all the time. Perhaps you can buy an attachment to your computer that has extended floppies so that you can stick all the floppies in at once so you don't have to keep changing things. Well, look at it this way. It beats the commands, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Because and without this operating system, you'd be stuck with all the commands.
Yeah, or
so,
another a similar 1980s graphical
yeah.
operating system that they've made that probably isn't
yeah.
anywhere near as good as this.
Well, I must admit, when you think of
yeah.
what the alternative is, which is using commands, this is a far improvement and much easier to use, I feel, that you don't need to memorise commands and refer to a book all the time.
And basically, if he had a time machine and he could travel back to the 1980s and say, look what I've made, and give it to the 1980s people on a floppy disk, imagine how they'd feel about this.
Oh, wow. He'd be...
It runs on their computers.
That would be just like a news item. Oh, hey, wow, check out this new technology. Isn't it just fantastic? I could just imagine that.
And since this was at the time before Windows 95, because think, that whole Start Mini thing came out in 1995, it would stuff up Windows. Microsoft wouldn't be able to go, hey, let's just make a Start Menu and copy this guy's idea.
I get what you mean.
So we would be, if he went back in time with this, everything would be totally different and maybe Microsoft wouldn't be dominating the market.
Well,
maybe Armstrong would. Neil Armstrong. Whatever
Amstrad.
It's called.
Who was the person that created this?
So this is the official SymbOS website. So if we go to facts and history, development began, he actually started it in the year 2000. And then he's been going on, look at all this time he's spent on it.
Wow.
All these years.
How dedicated is that?
I know. And then that's when he finally got SymbOS 1.0 released. Started 16 colour support, so you could have 16 colours on the screen at once rather than
I tell you four. What, this guy should get a gold medal for his persistence.
And then, and all this for free.
Yeah.
He's got like a donate button on his site, but he's doing it all for free. And where is it? This is, I think, where he, yeah, SymbOS 2.2, so this is the version we're trying out.
Yeah.
And then he kind of went off and he did other stuff for some years, see, and he was working on, making a Knight Rider, like, you know, the car in Knight Rider, yeah. A kit replica
or something. Do you know something? When I was 15 years old, we went to Disneyland, I actually sat in the kit Knight Rider car, and it's talked to me, so I'll never forget that experience.
And basically, yeah, now he's doing the whole preview December 21st, 2012, just after the world ended. He released his first preview of SymbOS 2.1, but then something's happened and the world must have literally ended and he hasn't released any more versions since then.
Oh, okay. Wow. I wonder what happened to him. Be interesting. Does anyone know?
I don't know.
But, no, I think... obviously, if you're back in the 80s, or if you're currently using an 80s computer, this is definitely a better alternative than running commands. Definitely.
Okay. And how much do you think right now, today, it would cost to buy one of the old computers that run this? Like, one of the old computers that you could stick a floppy disk into and run this operating system?
Well, it actually might be quite expensive because they're probably in a museum now.
So how much if you just wanted to buy one? How much do you think it would cost? And then we'll look at the price and see if you're right.
Oh, look, I'll take a stab in the dark. Let's say... Oh, well, look, it could really be anything. It could be... Somebody might be just trying to get rid of it as almost garbage. So it could be like $50, $20 or near offer.
I guess $1,500.
It's in a real, like...
Pristine.
Pristine condition, it's considered an antique... In which case, it would be even much more valuable than it was back in those days. So I estimate it could be $500.
Okay. So just out of, like, pure luck, we found on eBay that someone's selling a vintage Amstrad CPC 464 colour computer with a tape drive, right?
Yeah.
And there it is, the actual keyboard computer thing. And it's in really, really good condition, fantastic antique. There's even people selling these Amstrad little, you know, tape games and stuff for $3 and buy it now kind of thing. So that's all you're paying.
And this
very
one
cheap.
Is, at the moment, it's at $57.
$7.
It's at 10 bits.
And you've got an hour and 32 minutes left. I wonder what it started at and how... It'd be interesting to see how what it ends up going for.
It would. I just can't believe there's actually people out
there...
Yeah,
people bidding for these old computers. Yeah. 10 bids. Let's see what it started at. So it started at $10 and it's gone up to $57.
Mm-hmm.
So your last task now is how do you shut down the computer?
Okay, I presume I go down to the start menu here and simply shut down. What do you want the computer to do? Well, I just kind of clicked the shut down, so I want it to shut down. There we go, okay.
There we go, it shut down.
Wow.
Catch you next time on OS First Timer, possibly with the Commodore 64.
See ya.